Today we will see the topic verification, calibration and validation of module 5. Verification, calibration and validation is very much important in the simulation. So one of the most important and difficult tasks facing a model developer is the verification and validation of the simulation model. It is the job of the model developer to work closely with the end users throughout the period. So there is a lot of difference between verification and validation. So the verification and validation difference has to be needed to be identified properly. Verification is concerned with building the model right. Now it is utilized in comparison of the conceptual model to the computer representation that implements that conception. Next, the verification, the purpose of model verification is to assure that the conceptual model is reflected accurately in the operational model. Now we move on to the validation so that we can have a clear differentiation between what verification and validation is. So validation is concerned with building the right model. So there is difference between verification and validation. Verification is concerned with building the model right, and validation is concerned with building the right model. Next, validation is utilized to determine that a model is an accurate representation of the real system. It is usually achieved through the calibration of the model. Validation is the overall process of comparing the model and its behavior to the real system and its modeler. So these are the difference between verification and validation. Now we move on to the next slide, that is model building, verification and validation. So here the diagram represents the model building, verification and validation process. The first step in model building consists of observing the real system and the interactions among its various components and collecting data on its behavior. Operations, technicians, repair and maintenance personnel, engineers and supervisors and managers under certain aspects of the system which may be unfamiliar to others. And in model building, as model development proceeds, new question may arise and the model developers will return to this step of learning true system structure and behavior. The second step in the model building is the construction of conceptual model, a collection of assumptions on the components and the structure of the system, plus hypothesis on the values of the model input parameters, illustrated by the following figure which is being shown here. The third step is the translation of the operation model in a computer recognizable form, the computerized model. So model building, verification and validation has three steps. First one is the real system, second one is conceptual model, and the third step is operational model. Now we move on to verification of simulation models and calibration and validation of models. So calibration and validation of models, the diagram of calibration and verification of models is being provided here. So this is the diagram which represents the calibration and validation of models. So we have the real system here, we have the initial model, first version of the model and the second version of the model, where we can see from initial model to the first revision model we have a concept called as revise. From first revision model to the second revision model we have again revised. So here you can see this is the real system is being kept on revised to obtain the good result or the good system. So verification and validation, although are conceptually distinct, usually are connected simultaneously by the modeler. Validation is the overall process of comparing the model and its behavior to the real system and its behavior. Calibration is the iterative process of comparing the model to the real system, making adjustment to the models, comparing again, so on. The following diagram and the relationship of the model calibration to overall validation process is being shown. The comparison of the model to reality is carried out by variety of tests. So tests are subjective and objective. So there are two different kinds of sets tests which can be performed. So the first test is subjective and the second test is objective. Now we'll see what do you mean by subjective test and objective test. Subjective tests usually involve people who are knowledgeable about one or more aspects of the system, making judgments about the model and its inputs. Objective test always requires data on the system's behavior plus the corresponding data produced by the model. So here we can see the different kinds of test being performed. Next, we see here, or in this diagram or by this diagram, we have a person called as Naylor and Finger. They have formulated three-step approach, and it is called as Naylor and Finger three-step approach. So the three-step approach are: step one, build a model that has high face validity. Second step is validate model assumptions, and the third step is compare the model input output transformation to corresponding input output transformation for the real system. So now by this diagram we can see this is the system where calibration and validation of models is being seen clearly, where we have something of a calibration where real system is been considered and compared model to reality, and it's been checked whether the initial model is proper or not. In case the initial model is not proper, we go for revision of it, and by the revision of this we obtain another version that is called as first version of the model. And again the first version has been compared, and if the first version is again having some problem, again it has been revised and is been obtained with second revision of the model, and the revision keeps on continuing till we get a proper model. So this kind of procedure of keeping on revising is called as calibration, and the method obtained here is validation. Now we move on to the next slide, where we see calibration and validation of the models, where I had said we have three steps by Naylor and Finger. So three steps are face validity, second one is validation of model assumptions, and the third one is validating input output transformation. Now we'll see what you mean by face validity. The first goal of simulation modeler is to construct a model that appears reasonable on its face to model users and others who are acknowledgeable or knowledgeable about the real system being simulated. Next, the users of the model should be involved in the construction from the conceptualization to its implementation to ensure that a high degree of realism is built into the model through reasonable assumptions regarding system structure and reliable data. Next is another advantage of user involvement in the increase of the model perceived validity or credibility, without which manager will not be willing to trust simulation results as the basis of the decision making. Sensitivity analysis can also be used to check models' face validity. The modeler user is, or the model user is asked if the model behaves in the expected way when one or more input variables is changed. Based on the experience of observations on the real system, the model user and model builder would probably have some notation at least of the direction of change in model output when an input variable is increased or decreased. The model builder must attempt to choose the most critical input variables for testing if it is too expensive or time consuming to vary all input variables. So the first step, what we said, something of face validity is very much important. So face validity is dealing with the model and the modeler. So the model should be properly known by the modeler, and whatever inputs have been given and what kind of outputs to be expected is to be known by the modeler. Next, we move on to the next stage, that is validation of model assumptions. So model assumptions fall into two general categories. The first category is called as structural assumptions, and the second category is data assumptions. So now we'll see what do you mean by structural assumptions and what do you mean by data assumptions. So some of the assumptions has to be performed in the model that belongs to structural and data. So structural assumptions involve questions of how the system operates and usually involve simplification and abstractions of reality. For example, consider the customer queuing and service facility in a bank. Customers may form one line, or there may be an individual line for each teller. If there are many lines, customer may be served strictly on a first come first serve basis, or some customers may change lines if one is moving faster. The number of tellers may be fixed or variable. These structural assumptions should be verified by actual observations during the appropriate time periods, together with the decisions and discussions with the managers and tellers regarding bank policies and actual implementation of these policies. So this is an example which clearly tells you what is structural assumption. Next, we move on to data assumptions. So data assumption should be based on the collection of reliable data and correct statistical analysis of the data. So whichever data has been collected, it has to be verified and seen whether the data is reliable or correct, and statistical analysis has to be performed. So that is called as data assumptions. Next, we move on to validating input transformation. In this phase of validation process, the model is viewed as input-output transformation. That is, the model accepts the values of the input parameter and transforms these inputs into output measures of performance. It is this correspondence that is being validated. Next, instead of validating the model input-output transformation by predicting the future, the modeler may use past historical data which has been served for validation purpose. That is, if one set has been used to develop calibrate the model, it's recommendation that a separate data test be used as final validation test. So here it clearly tells that previous or history can be used to identify whether the model is proper or not. Thus, accurate prediction of the past may replace a prediction of the future for purpose of validating the future. A necessary condition for input-output transformation is that some version of the system under study exists, so that the system data under at least one set of input condition can be collected to compare to model prediction. Now, in validating input-output transformation, if the system is in planning stage and no system operating data can be collected, complete input-output data validation is not possible. So if the stage of the model development is in planning stage, the data being collected may not be complete or it cannot be validated properly. Next, validation increases modeler's confidence that the model of existing system is accurate. Changes in the computerized representation of the system, ranging from relatively minor to relatively major, may include. So there may be some minor changes and there may be few major changes during the validation. So few examples, or we'll see what you mean by minor changes and major changes. Minor changes of single numerical parameters such as speed of machine, arrival rate of the customer, etc. And next, minor changes of the form of a statistical distribution such as distribution of service time or time to failure of a machine is considered as minor changes. Some of the examples have been taken for major changes. So major changes in the logical structure of a subsystem, such as change in queue discipline for waiting line model or a change in scheduling rule for a job shop model, and all are the major changes. Another major changes involving a different design for the new system, such as computerized inventory control system replacing a non-computerized system. So there may be few minor changes and there will be lot of major changes. So minor changes can be easily accepted, but major changes may affect the model. So now we finish with the module, that is the fifth module, and the topic, it is verification, calibration and validation of simulation models. Thank you.